Chris Mackowski of Emerging Civil War, and I'm with my friend Tim Talbott, Director of Education and Interpretation of Pamplin Historical Park, which is where we're spending the day today. And Tim has agreed to spend some time with me to explore the park and the story of Petersburg. Tim, thanks for having us today.
Oh, thanks for coming to share what we have with our visitors. We're really fortunate to be able to share a little bit of time with you today and show you a little bit of what's here.
So what we're going to do is a series of videos exploring the park. We're going to parse those out over the course of the next few days so that you can have the chance to virtually explore Pamplin. But I can't stress enough, come here in person, because Tim, the resources here are pretty incredible. And let's face it, you've got the spot where the Confederate Army broke.
Yeah, that's really the highlight and why the park was started, is to preserve the Confederate earthworks that were snapped by the Sixth Corps on the morning of April 2nd, 1865. But in addition to that, as you'll see throughout the day here, we've got tons of stuff to learn. We've got the National Museum of the Civil War Soldier right behind us. We've got the Tudor Hall Plantation. We've got the Breakthrough Battlefield itself and our Battlefield Center. So there's lots to see and do here, a full day's worth of activities. Really, you could spend a whole day here.
And one of the things that I've always been impressed about with Pamplin is that it's well-maintained, it's just well-groomed. The visitor experience I've had every time I've been here has just been first class. Kudos to you and your colleagues and your staff for that. And it's really interactive. I mean, there's just a lot of stuff to do rather than just stuff to look at here.
Right. We've tried to put the visitor in the shoes of the people of the time. And one of the things that we really try to push here is learning history through multiple perspectives, whether that's in the National Museum of the Civil War Soldier, where you choose a soldier and go through the museum, or in the Tudor Hall, we have a video that talks about different perspectives on slavery in the 1850s. We're always trying to tell people or teach people history through multiple lenses.
And you've got, of course, North and South, you've got free and enslaved, you've got military and civilian, and all that's encapsulated in the story you're telling here.
Yeah, and I think that's important to remember. When you hear Pamplin Historical Park, a lot of people don't know exactly what to expect. Sure, we are the National Museum of the Civil War Soldier, and that's a big focus of what we do, the common soldier's experience. But that Southern history, the antebellum history, is also a big focus on what we try to share with people.
So give us a little preview as we're gonna explore the park today. What are some of the things we're gonna hit on?
So we'll go and visit a little bit of the National Museum of the Civil War Soldier. We'll certainly go over and visit Tudor Hall, where General Samuel McGowan is gonna make his headquarters while they're here defending these lines.
That man's a bullet magnet.
He caught a couple, yes. Yeah, during his career, he certainly was. And then we'll visit the Battlefield Center, which is housing our current exhibit on United States Colored Troops, our temporary exhibit. And then we'll take a little visit out to the Breakthrough Battlefield as well.
Very good. So lots of cool stuff for us to see and explore. As I said, I want you guys to come down here in person, and we're going to spend the next couple videos teasing you in order to get you to come down. Tim, thanks so much for having us down here today.
Thank you very much for coming.
More to come. I'm Chris Mackowski, Tim Talbott at Pamplin Historical Park. More to come today.